So this was all about your graph section. In this chapter, you have to study two types of graph, bar graph and double bar graph. These two examples are hopefully clear to you now. Now the next topic and the last topic of your chapter is probability. Now this is the first time you must be hearing about this word. So I would just explain you in detail. Now whenever you toss a coin or you throw a dice or you are playing a match, there are chances that you can win or you lose. You don't know the future, that what is going to happen. You don't know that whether you will lose or you will win. If you are playing a cricket match, do you know that you are going to win or you are going to lose? No, but you can make a chance or you can make a result that I could win. Both chances are half-half. So that chances is called probability in mathematical terms. Now probability refers to the chances of any event likely to occur. Like when you are playing a match, the chances that you win is a one type of probability, and chances of losing is also one type of probability. Now it, if you can see, it highlights the word event. Now what do event means? Event means one or more outcomes of an experiment. Like when you are playing the match, which are the outcomes? Either you will win or either you will lose. That is called an event. When you check that probability of winning, so that will become an event. Next is outcomes. Now outcome means the result of the experiment. Like what I have said, that when you are playing a cricket match, what will be your outcomes? Win or lose. So that things are called, the results of an experiment done are called outcomes. Now how to find probability? Probability has one formula which you have to remember. Probability is equals to number of outcomes upon total number of outcomes. See, for example, I have given tossing of a coin. See, tossing of a coin becomes an experiment that we are doing. Like tossing a coin, we are doing an experiment. What will be its outcomes? That is head and tail. So how many total number of outcomes are there? Two. One is head, other is tail. Now you have to test a probability of getting a head. Now getting a head becomes an event. Now, to find what is the probability of getting a head, you have to write the formula first. Probability equals to number of outcomes upon total number of outcomes. So now, probability of getting a head will be, head comes how many times? One time. So 1 upon, what are the total number of outcomes? 2. So it will be 1 upon 2. Keep this in mind that probability always lies between 0 to 1. It cannot exceed 1 and cannot be negative. Probability is always between 0 and 1. This one is an example for your understanding. When a dice is thrown, find the probability of getting a 3, an even number, and 7. See, the most simplest way of solving the sums of probability is first write down the outcomes of the event. Write down the outcomes of the event. Now, outcomes of a dice will be how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, how many total number of outcomes are there? 6. Now, you have to find the probability of 3. So, firstly, commonly write the formula of probability. Probability equals to number of outcomes upon total number of outcomes. First one, probability of getting a 3. Now, if you can see in the outcomes of a dice, 3 comes only 1 time, so it will be 1 upon 6. Probability of getting an even number. How many even numbers are there? 2, 4 and 6. So there are 3 even numbers. So it will be 3 upon 6, which is equals to 1 upon 2. Probability of getting a 7. Is there any 7 number in the dice? No, so it will be 0. So it will be 0 upon 6, which is equals to 0. So this is one of the common example of probability. You will be asked examples related to it. So we have completed with our chapter data handling. You will have to solve exercise number 3.3 and 3.4 today in a graph book, and be careful to write scale and x-axis, y-axis. Thank you. See you soon.